When you look over the course of your life, there is always one or two people that you think about and you think, wow, if I hadn't have seen that person, if I hadn't have met that person, if I hadn't have been influenced the way I was by that person, I would not be where I am today. I may have never decided to go into the field that I'm in. Today I want to talk about having mentors, why it is so important to have people to look up to and aspire to be like, why everyone needs one, how you can be one, and why it is so important to thank them before it's too late. I think one of the misconceptions about having a mentor is that it has to be somebody you know. A lot of people have mentors that might be a parent, a grandparent, an aunt, an uncle, maybe a teacher, maybe somebody who has just really influenced them throughout the course of their lives. And that's very common to have somebody that you know, maybe a friend, maybe somebody in the same field that you're in. But there are also mentors that we never have the chance to meet. People we see on television, people we hear on the radio, people we read about in books and magazines. These people are also mentoring us without even knowing it. It doesn't matter what kind of mentor or person that you aspire to be like that you have in your life, whether you know them or whether you don't, it's still incredibly important to have people that we can turn to and look at for inspiration to help keep us going, to help keep us motivated, and to help realize that we can actually become whatever it is that we hope to be in our lives. You're probably thinking about the person who has inspired you the most in your life. Today, I want to just quickly encourage you to take the time to reach out to these people, whether they are a neighbor, like I said, someone that you know on a day-to-day level, or if they are someone who is super famous or was super famous at one time. You can find a way to reach out to these people and tell them how important they were to you. The reason I think that this is so important is because without even knowing it, you are probably that person to another human. And when someone reaches out to you and says, thank you so much for helping me, for inspiring me, for being someone that has really pushed me into doing things that I might not have otherwise done, that is a feeling so incredibly good that I think everyone in the world deserves to feel that. I have several mentors and several people that I looked up to when I was a child growing up, from family members to people that I saw on my television to people that I saw in concert. And if you know me, you probably know who these people are. I want to take a quick minute to just mention a few of them. The very first people to ever inspire me musically were my parents. They listened to music around the house. My dad would sing to my mom's pregnant belly when she was pregnant with me because he heard that it would help make the baby musical, which it did. That worked. Thank you, Dad. And, you know, just being introduced to music as a small child, I think I was destined for that future. My parents were so kind to introduce me to television shows that also had really great music. Now, the very first television show that I ever saw that involved music and a live performance was Sharon Lois and Bram's Elephant Show. And if you know me, then you know how deeply influenced I was by this trio, especially by Lois. Lois Lilienstein was by far my first and biggest influence in my life and in my career. I remember the first time I ever saw her perform. I was in a small theater in Boston with my parents. They had taken me to see Sharon Lois and Bram. And the three of them walked out on stage and instantly I was fixated on Lois. There was something about her energy. She had this sparkle and this overwhelming sense of happiness about what she was doing, what she was singing, what she was saying. Throughout my life, I've always thought about her. I have always gone back and watched episodes of The Elephant Show. I have definitely really looked at her my whole life as being someone that had a huge impact on my life's decision to go into music. About 3 years ago, I decided that I couldn't wait any longer to thank her. So I sent her a detailed letter thanking her for all of the things that she had done to change my life. I found a way to get to her through not the simplest way. I had to go through about two or three people to actually reach her. And once I finally did, I got an email back from Sharon and from Bram, and they told me that Lois received my email, and Sharon wanted me to know what an impact my letter and my words had made on her. Lois was incredibly sick at the time. I had no idea that she was. I just had this overwhelming sense of, I need to tell her right now, I have to thank her for everything she's done for me in my life. I needed her to understand the magnitude of her influence over me. 20 days after my letter reached her, Lois passed away. And that has been something that has deeply affected me. If I had have waited just a couple more weeks to tell her, I would not have been given the chance to connect with her at all, because it would have been too late. I consider myself incredibly lucky that I did have the chance to tell her via email. So I want that little story to kind of inspire you and to bring it to your attention that telling someone else how much they have meant to you and what you have done because of their influence over you, it's never a bad decision to reach out to someone and thank them for that kind of thing. Another person that I really want to mention is another woman who had a huge influence over me as a child and in my adult life. And that person is Ann Jillian. Ann Jillian is an incredible actress, singer. She has been in amazing shows. She is so multi-talented. And I think having a person like that influence me as a child made a really big impact on me. My parents turned on Alice in Wonderland when I was a little girl, and Ann Jillian played the Red Queen. The song that stood out to me from that entire two-part movie was Emotions, which was the song that she sang. And I'll never forget trying to mimic her vibrato and her little movements and the things that she did while she was singing that song. And I've thought about it over the years about how lucky I was to grow up in a time when there were women like Ann Jillian and Lois Lilienstein on my television set. Women that were strong and classy and really deeply talented, that had worked very hard to get to the point of being on television and being in the public eye. Fast forward a lot of years, I decided I wanted to thank Ann Jillian for her deep influence over my life. It took me a very long time to try and reach her. But when I finally did, she was kind enough to send me an email. Not only did she thank me for my words and made me feel that my gratitude to her was felt deeply and that it really did mean something to her, but at the bottom of her email, she wrote some words that I will forever keep in my heart. Those words were, "Stay happy, stay determined, enjoy every moment, be wise, love yourself, and always keep God in your heart." I have actually emailed with Ann back and forth several times, not only because I wanted her to know how much I look up to her and admire her, but because she is somebody that has mentored me throughout my life, and she is somebody that I've never even met in person. I couldn't go any longer without thanking her. And it has meant so much to me to have that connection with her. So the reason I'm telling you this is because I really want you to take the time to thank these people. Mentors, idols, heroes, whatever you want to call them, are so important. Whether you think it or not, you are probably having some influence over another person. Try to be wise in the choices that you are making in your career, whether you're posting things online, whether you are sharing videos and content on social media, because there is always going to be a little girl or a little boy who is going to see you and they're going to make the choice of, I want to be like this person or I don't. And if they do want to be like you and they look to you for mentorship or inspiration, remember that the decisions you make in your career and the choices that you make when posting content online, whether it's positive or negative, are going to affect another person. If you are in the music business or in the entertainment business at all, you have a responsibility, in my opinion, to be the best version of yourself when it comes to presenting yourself in front of another person. Just be wise about the way that you handle that responsibility. And if you see another person that is in need of a little love and inspiration and guidance, and you're in the position to do that for them, step up and help them. Because someday the tables may turn and you may receive a letter from another person saying, thank you so much for what you did for me. Because of you, I decided to do this with my life and I want to thank you. Life goes by really quickly and the tables turn without you even realizing they're turning. And I just wanted to talk to you today about that, my feelings about it, the women who have inspired me the most in entertainment, and encourage you to go forward with your day thinking about the people who have meant a lot to you. Be sure and thank them and remind yourself daily that you could also be that person for someone else. I hope you have a wonderful day. If you haven't, quickly take the time to subscribe to my channel. It would mean everything to me. And I hope you have a truly inspiring and wonderful week.